I have some fabric that I've been ripping up here. This one was some Dollar Tree fabric. Mm. Let me show you. They come in these little rolls like this for a buck and a quarter. The Dollar-ish Tree, I should call it, right? The Dollar-ish Tree. And tonight we're going to be working with, let me show you that first. The new Totally Dazzled Pen of the Month for September is the new Totally Dazzled Pen of the Month for September. This beautiful fall leaf. So this is the Dollar Tree fabric. All I do is I take my good scissor and I go, I made some of them kind of a little bit wider. And I just cut little slits just like this all the way down. It's pretty simple. You can look at how easy that rips, right? Boom, you got a piece of ripped fabric. You can So that's what we're gonna be doing tonight. So I wanna show you some of the stuff I've ripped today. Look at this one. I love this one. This just screams fall. This was all Dollar Tree, y'all. That one. Here's the tablecloths. Let me just show you. They were nice. They were king size, brand new king size sheets. We've got the same thing. You just go along the edge, and this one, though, doesn't rip this way. The cotton, if you have 100% cotton, it's going to rip both ways because of the way it's woven. If you have any other type of fabric woven in, it's not gonna rip both ways, it's only gonna rip one way. So this is the way it rips. And so I went ahead and I made a whole bunch of cuts and I just did this over and over and over. And they get stringy and all you do is you just pull some of the strings out. Half of the beauty of making a rag bow is that it looks raggedy, right? We like that. So what I'm gonna do here, let me show you what I got. This is a Dollar Tree sign, little board. It's a real wood board. I don't know, maybe it's particle board. I don't know, but anyway. I took it and I had my husband actually drill two holes here and I put these are probably like quarter inch dowel rods down in there and glued them in. And then I marked it from 1 inch to 9 inches here, and well, this whole thing is 17 inches long, the whole board, 17 inches long. So centered, it's 9 inches here, and it would be 9.5, I guess, center. But anyway, no, it would be 8.5, right? Yeah, it would be 8.5 if it was actual center, but we did this. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a piece of this twine. And we're gonna create the smaller part, the part of the bow that that's the pretty part, you know, the bow, not the tails. We're gonna create that, okay? Anyway, improvising. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this Tim Holtz and I'm gonna just distress it a little bit, just a little, like that. I'm just gonna shabby it up. Like this, pull it through. The Tim Holtz, this ink is called Vintage Photo. It is distress ink by Tim Holtz. You've probably seen it before. I get it at Hobby Lobby. You probably get it, probably at Michael's. You could probably get it at all sorts of places. You probably get it at Joann's. So all I'm gonna do is run it through, and you can see some of the edges are getting a little bit darker than the others. So I'm gonna make sure that I put the white side up so that the stained side is more visible. Does that make sense? Well, some of it will be up anyway, but that's just the way it is. Okay, but we're gonna start with the white side up and just crisscross back and forth, back and forth. In the front, and they're gonna be a little bit smallish in the front. They're not that long, okay? So I'm almost thinking maybe just make them go into thirds, maybe, instead of the way I did. I had four fourths. I think I'm gonna go into thirds, make these a little bit smaller, like that. Like that. Okay, and I'm gonna alternate some of these colors. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this string and just kind of tie it off. I'm going to pull everything up off of the dowels and just kind of keep it all. Actually, I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to flip this around so the sunflower shows pretty. Hold on. I fix that last one because it is, I digress here. This one should have went face up first so that the third one would be face up like that. Does that make sense to anybody but me? Okay, and then I'm going to flip the whole thing because I want the white to be on the bottom and the tie to be on the bottom of the white. So making sure it's centered before I snug it up. Give it a good pull. And knot it. Okay, and then I can fluff it. Just fluffing it up. And what I like to do is I just like to take the edges, the loops, and just kind of give them a little yank and separate them. Just take the loop. All right, now this is what we've got, but we can also take the white ones and do the same thing. You kind of got this going on for the bow. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip it around and I'm going to separate the white ones as well. Look at that. It just came to life, y'all. It just came to life, didn't it? I love that. Isn't that pretty? Look at how colorful. How cute. So I have taken this sheet that I got. It was a table cover for the wedding. And I have taken it and I have ripped it into shreds, into lots of these tails, right? Lots of tails. So what I'm going to do is the same thing. I'm going to take my little vintage photo. It's called Vintage Photo Distress Ink by Tim Holtz. It looks like that. At Hobby Lobby, you can get it. And I'm just gonna run it right across my desk here. Let's see if I come in more. Wow, there's a lot on this roll. Might not even have to open the other one because I've got other trims that I'm going to be using, so I might not have to. Wouldn't that be nice? And they don't have to be perfectly the same length or any of that jazz. Just and here's the fun part, putting the tails together. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna find the middle ish of each piece and I'm going to start building a bow. Okay, find the middle of each piece and just kind of scrunch it in the middle like that. Okay, I think that's really full and pretty looking. Just gonna tie it in the middle here. This is the middle. With some twine. You're not going to see the metal because you're going to put the bigger, the bow on top. So it really doesn't matter. You could even use the jute if you like that look as part of it. Let it just hang down. Yeah, I really won't see it. So I am loving this. I don't know about you all, but I love this. All right, and we're going to take the tails from the bow, right? And we're going to tie it right into the middle, find the middle again, of the tails. Let's see. Isn't that pretty? Doesn't that scream fall? You could put this on your door, on your front door. You could put it on a wreath. This would be beautiful on a grapevine wreath. I think it would be so pretty. So we're gonna dazzle this baby up. Now, we've got the pen of the month, which is this beautiful leaf. And I have pumpkins. I have pumpkins from last year. The leaf, I'm going to use a few of them actually. I can pen them in the center, or these don't have pins, so I will have to glue them to the center. This pumpkin in the middle, and these two on the sides, and bling it up in the center. So I'm going to put some B7000 on this. I'm going to call this the center pumpkin right here, and I'm going to add some hot glue to the middle here, kind of pull it in the middle. I could use two of these leaves and put two of the leaves, the fall leaves, going this way and put the pumpkin in the middle. Let's just hold this up and show you how stinking cute. Let me just make sure that this is all going in the right direction. Because some of it is, I'm going to do a little trimming here. Cute, y'all. Is that not pretty?
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.